The following is a presentation of Retro Sports Network, home of the champions of the past, present, and or future. Hello. Oops. No, that is me. Haha. My name is Ron Chuckett. Welcome to the program. We promise you one more stream before we get back into doing our streaming thing. And so I actually picked up Action PC Football 2022 and going to give a modified first look of the game. My first instincts are, from playing just a few minutes of it, is there's some good changes with the game, and let's hope that in the quarter that we're about to do between the Buccaneers and the Rams from this past season from L.A., that that you'll like the changes in it too. So we'll go through what I've seen and play a little bit of football and all of that. I will say right off the bat, because I know I'm going to be asked, as far as modding is concerned, if you've modded one football game, you've modded them all. There are no changes in that respect. Okay? So let's set up an exhibition game and let's play some football. It's what the main screen looks like. And I don't have pictures for everybody. We can figure that out at some point. It really isn't all that important for what I want to do, especially this year, but there are some teams I wanted. So here's Tampa Bay. And here are the world champion Los Angeles Rams. And you'll notice that the font and windows here are a lot bigger than what they were. And so it makes it easier to read. You can... especially for those of us who have older eyes. How about that? So, good weather, exhibition game. I did put the logos in for those two. As we said again, this is also a larger screen, which I think should make it quite a bit easier to read. Here are my game display settings. I don't do the team colors, that's all. There are notable pop-ups. I wonder how new those are. I'm not going to put photos on the field. I noticed that you now get an alert when the offense changes quarterback. Considering I usually play with both offenses, I would do that myself. Also, it alerts me when a skill player initially enters the game. You can now change it, I guess, to... never, beginning, first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter. That's new. Defensive play call list color. White selected, but you can change it to yellow, red, green, and cyan. And display the fatigue chart when players are below 80, which it's done for a long time anyway. So it just tells you what players you shouldn't be using. Scoreboard display. Okay, so let's play with some of the scoreboard. Display standard. Classic, stack teams, split teams. I do stack teams. Stats, expanded, none, or basic. All right, we'll leave it with expanded. Team colors and home team big plays. All right, let's try that. See what that looks like. Offensive play, player call playlist. Ah. Expanded playlist, which I believe is the default, or a basic playlist. So if you don't want to be super advanced, you can just call the basic plays. We'll just leave it as expanded because that's what I'm used to. Display offensive play box. Click on play or player or mouse over play or player. That's new. Normally it's been click on the play or a player. So if I want to go to a specific player, I just click on it. Or if I go to a specific play, and you've seen me do both in before. Select offensive play, single click, so you just click and go. Or double click, same with defensive play. Field display, that's what I have it set up. I have all the chalkboard pop-ups. And I think you'll like what they got this year. Sound, game action sound, referee volume, oop, okay, and touchdown fight songs. You can do national anthems and pregame music, press box narrator and all that happy horse stuff. I'm gonna turn all this down. Okay. So that's how I have it set up. We're ready. Here we go. That's the more conventional size screen. You know these players. It's Tom Brady and Matthew Stafford, for goodness sakes. And so that's that SoFi Stadium or SoFi Stadium. Clear with a little bit of wind. 72 degrees. You'd think you were playing in Southern California or something like that. So the coin toss, Tampa wins. We'll defer. And LA will take the field goal or take the football. So they'll return Powell, Sony Michel, and Funk. Vincent Price's best friend, right? Are the upmen. And so we'll kick this puppy away. And the Rams, Brandon Powell, for Bradley Pinion is the kicker. We'll just down it and take it at the 25. Again, this is one of the things I noticed. Let me get that off the screen here. The default formation is a three wide receiver, one running back set. The Rams have two of those. They can go with a two wide receiver, two running back set. And then they can go back to the three wide receiver, one running back, three wide receiver, two running back. I think that's going to make it a lot easier to call general offenses when that is the what they're actually using. These hash marks are kind of narrow. We'll see, because we're playing with hash marks on, how much of a difference that actually makes. So first play from scrimmage. You click on Darrell Henderson Jr. And we'll try a sweep to the right. We're not going to audible. We'll stick with the play call. Henderson goes up there. He gets a bit of a block, and Barrett makes the tackle. And you can see where the football is now on the far hash. And I like that. So Shaquille Barrett with the tackle. Henderson gets a gain of 4, second down and 6. Regular pass play. Hamlin, you hear the crowd. Hopefully that's not overpowering. Hamlin is going to get a medium slant. That screen hasn't changed. So Stafford back to pass. He goes over the middle, and that's incomplete right through the hands of Davis. It'll be third down and 6 for the Rams on their own 29. So I like how that's there. When I played earlier today, I used the default fields, and it really showed off the sideline stuff. So third down and 6 with 3 wide. Let's turn down the sound a bit. Sounded loud to me. Alright, so third down and 6. Obviously 3 wide. Short cross to Woods. Flag is down.
False start.
Now
offense,
that screen is considerably bigger.
Penalty, repeat, third down.
If I move it, it really does fill the screen. And again, I think it's the first of Dave's games to kind of really go for the older eyes. I think that would be a lot easier to see and figure out. So it's third down and 11. I'm already at a 3 wide receiver set. So we're going to go out of the gun, man in motion, medium slant, again to Woods. So you see the man in motion. Stafford has time. He finds Woods over the middle. And Dean with a tackle. That's a gain of 14. Not sure if that's the correct Robert Woods, but the picture shows up. And that play analysis and defense plus or minus, that hasn't changed. Now, on the clock thing, it says the next play will be running 30 to 40 seconds. That's new. That's the main thing. They've had a version of that before. I can go into a hurry up and it'll tell me 18 to 22, or I can run some clock and it'll be a 39-second runoff. Let's go 2-2. Henderson and Michelle out of the eye. Does not keep you in the shotgun. Sony, off tackle right. And you can see the ball carrier, and Sony is hit by Sue for a gain of 2. How do you do? So, second down and 8 for the Rams. I can stick with that formation. Go 4 wide. Odell Beckham came in late. So, we're going to run a 4 wide receiver set. Medium hitch to Beckham. Stafford flush throws incomplete. And Antoine Winfield Jr. made the deflection. So third down and 8 for the Rams. We'll give everyone just a couple possessions here. We can go no huddle. The clock has stopped, so you can't choose any of that. That'll show you the lineups and the fatigue, by the way, as I'm working on the bottom right part of the screen. And shows their ratings against for the run and the pass. In-game box score. Don't really ever show that enough, but that looks to be about the same. Stats page, if you ever wonder, because you can do that and keep track of who's doing what. Their usage, although we don't really have usage penalty. I don't use usage penalties. If you want to know how your... Again, the brain fog is still a bit there. How your skill players are doing as far as fatigue are concerned, that's good. That's the screen you use. And the matchups, if you care about things like that. Year-to-date, team offense and defense. And the scouting. And just tells you what the computer has done against you in certain situations. I always just leave it on the percentage, personally. But nothing looks new there, but I'm not sure that we've ever shown that off. So third down and 8. Short little hitch to Henderson on third and 8. Stafford throws. Henderson's got it. He's got a first down. And David makes a tackle at midfield. So a first tackle, first and 10 for the Rams, right on the midfield stripe. The lineup screens, by the way, are pretty much the same. They can tell you, wow, Cup had 145 receptions, huh? Who you can put in and all that. By formation, here's the Rams' defensive sets. And the special teams, and that'd be the one I would keep an eye on. One of the things that they had to work on from before was the ever-disappearing long snapper and holder. But it looks like there are as many as a whole bunch of different punt returners and kick returners, so that's good. So first and 10 from midfield, ball on the 50. Cameron on a medium slant. Stafford rolls over to Henderson. Henderson gets a gain of 7. And that chalkboard is pretty fast. It's also very smooth. David, by the way, a second tackle. So let's slow that down a little bit. I think. You can also go with a vertical field and horizontal video, by the way. I'm not going to do the expanded field during the video chalkboard. That was a pain in the neck last year. Second down and 3. That's a run play here. So let's do that. Sony Michel. Trap left. Out of the eye, give to Michel. Sony, the one and only, gets a gain of 5. David with a tackle. So good opening possession here, and you can see it shifting on the field where the hash marks are. It doesn't necessarily have to be lined up with what you got for graphics. The default fields are all good. And so I like that. I think that gives it the game a little more depth. So first and 10. Ooh, they set that one up. So Michelle in the backfield. Let's look at Robert Woods, shall we? Let's do a medium cross to Robert Woods. Stafford over the middle. Woods has it. First down. And that Dean guy, Jamel Dean, with a second tackle. So first and 10, a gain of 12. And the Rams are moving the ball down the field. 54 net yards. Stafford 4 for 6 for 43. And they've run the ball three times for 11 yards. Michelle off tackle left. There's a flag down.
False start.
Somebody
offense,
jumped.
Number 89, 5-yard penalty.
And again,
repeat,
I like the fact that
down.
That's a lot bigger. So first and 15 for the Rams on the Tampa 31. What's Beckham going to do? Let's do a short slam. Stafford back to throw. Beckham's got it in stride. And Murphy bunting with a tackle after a gain of 9. So they get 9 on first and 15. Second and 6. 9.5 to go. Again, this is the expanded play calling. I think you can actually do basic play calling and just have the inside run, outside run, run left or right, run right, right on your screen. And I like that. I think it makes it a lot simpler for those trying to figure it out. Ball is put right between the hash marks. Second down and 6. Michelle on a sweep to the right side. Sony goes up to the far side and is hit by Vay for no gain. Vita Vay. So third and 6, and you can see the ball is spotted on the far side hash. I like that. I think that's very nice. So third down and 6. We'll stay 3 wide. Flat pass to Michelle. Stafford flush, going to scramble. That still is pretty fast. He gets a gain of 3. Golson is tired. That shows up white. How nice. And so we'll bring out the kicker here. 99% chance of that. Gay. Matt Gay. Again, that's all pretty there. We got a holder. We got a kicker. We could fake. Nothing new there. But they're going from the right side hash. And Gay chips it around for 37 yards and a field goal. So the Rams draw first blood. And so they're going to kick Darden, back deep, Mickens, and Bernard. And 8 yards deep, Tom Brady and company are going to take it at the 25. So double tight end set is the Bucks' default formation, okay, with Fournette. And the other setup here is for other wide receivers, and of course Gronk the tight end. So Fournette off tackle left, a good way to run. Flag is down, and Donald
offense number 76
with the tackle
penalty.
But a hold by Smith, and that's there. I saw someone was talking about a lack of penalties. That's apparently not a problem for me. First and 20 for Tampa on their own 15. Let's see what Gronk can do, shall we? He and Yeller are the tight ends. Let's go a medium slant to Gronk. Brady back to in the pocket, throws to Gronk, and Rob is brought down by Fuller for a gain of 17. There you go, second down and 3 from the Tampa 32. Don't necessarily agree with the color for Tampa. I thought it was more of a darker red. That kind of looks like those colors would be confused for Kansas City Chiefs. Leonard Fournette, sweep left, goes to the far side, and Leonard will get the first down. Reeder, Troy Reeder with it. No, they're short. So third down in inches. We'll go triple tight end, and Brady will sneak it. There we go. Brady waits for the seas to part, gets a first down. Aaron Donald with a tackle. So first and 10 for Tampa. Now we're going to set up with Jones in the backfield. Two wide receivers set, an old-fashioned football specialty. Ronald Jones. They did run it quite a bit. We'll throw out of it. How about that? Heath Evans. Stick with the play call. Brady. Quick throw to Evans. First down. And Evans is brought down after a gain of 12. Is that Heath Evans? Fuller's coming out. No, Mike Evans. And that's not that Mike Evans, I don't think. So first and 10, 5:13 to go. Bucks lined up on the near side on their own 48. Brayton and Gronkowski, the tight ends. So we'll go in motion. We'll look for Brayton, Cameron Brayton. And Cameron on a short slant. Wide receiver in motion. Brady chucks it down to Fournette and won't get a thing out of that. It'll be second and 10 for Tampa. So Leonard will try to sweep to the left. I believe it's the far side. He goes far side. He gets over midfield. Cuts over first down, 30. And he's chased out of bounds by Ernest Jones at the 27, a gain of 25. And so first and 10 for the Bucks. Again, Uncle Ron is not feeling super, super, super yet, but we're feeling pretty good. So first and 10 on the Ram 27. Six plays, 58 yards. Tampa has run it three times for 29, and Brady two for three for 29 yards. Godwin on a short slant. Brady back to throw. Wolves around for Fournette. Leonard gets a first down. And L.A. will challenge the spot of that. They have two remaining. They'll keep it if they get it.
Upon further review, the runner will stop short of the first down. No timeout will be charged.
And so the Rams don't get charged a timeout. Challenge worked. So second down in inches for Tampa Bay with 4:13 to go in the first quarter. Surprised that they're saying the stadium is open with wind, especially with all the stuff they got on the roof. That massive scoreboard. So second down and short. Short out to Fournette. How about that? Brady to throw. Can't find Fournette. Can't find anybody. So third down in inches. Tom 3 for 5 for 39 yards. Fournette is tired. And so we'll bring in Jones, the second, who can run. Jones just going to go on the dive play here. Give from Brady. First down, maybe Floyd? No. We won't challenge it. You don't keep your challenge, by the way. I should know that. So first and 10, 4:05 to go in the first quarter. Mike Evans on a medium cross as Tampa trying to score. Brady finds Evans. Touchdown. So not bad. Let's take a look at our first replay. That works. Nice. And we try for the extra point. And Abdullah will hit it. All right. So that's how the game itself works. I like a lot of the animation, I think, is very smooth. I think the best he's had in a while. I didn't have a turnover when I played earlier. We obviously didn't have a turnover in the time that we spent together with this. So I can't tell you if the turnover thing will slow it down like it has in the past. But the replays look good. The animation is smoother. And again, I love the fact that hash marks now make a difference. So let's take a look at some individual cards, shall we? So Aaron Rodgers, again, I don't need logos there, played his college ball at California, and just like Alex Rodriguez, he's named A-Rod, and so that's what those look like in the stats. Real replay in game, so you could click on it in the game and see that. Had a monster year, as you can tell. Play results. So every time that Rodgers ran a specific play intended for him, Obviously, he's going to be receiving. He could rush in his passes. It goes attempts, completion percentage, yards average, interceptions, interception percentage, sack, touchdowns, and you know how that works. Game logs. Injury history, that's new. Okay. His history, only in replays. The coaching settings, and so that's when you would have it, and the formations that you'd run. And oh, now they have preferred side of the field. That's pretty cool. And his overall ratings and that and Era Plus. And he's very good for the interceptions. And just kind of pass completion is about average. And pass yards per completion is a little bit above average. So I like that. That is quite cool. So that's how the quarterback cards look. Let's take a look at Mr. Cup, Cooper Cup, because I obviously messed up his name. Same shows the percentages, durability, and so strong, so he'll stay in the game, and penalties would be fewer against him. You can change all those. We'll go through the rules and such in a moment. 145 passing receptions. Allen, and they now have, you know, after the catch, I believe. So he had 873 yards of that for, and almost 2,000 yards in the air. That's pretty good. So the same thing with that. Okay. Rules. Let's see what they got for us this year in the rules. We now play a 17-game season. You can obviously set the kickoff line. If you didn't want, you could actually have a 4th and 15 option instead of a kickoff. How about that? You can choose where the goalpost is, where the field goal miss line is, touchbacks. You can actually set the 30. So it looks like if you wanted to play like some XFL, I think. Don't hold me to that. I honestly don't know. But there's a whole variety of rules. Extra point kick line to 15. Or the 2. So you can change that. 10-minute ticker. High school rules. You can have those if you want. 2-point conversions. Allow kneels. Allow spikes. Special teams covering option 2016 to present. That's new to me. Special team coverage option is available for pro teams 2016 to present. Special teams rating points from the 3 special team players listed on the lineup screen. Adjust opponent return averages. Oh, very nice. Players may be assigned to special teams via the roster screen. Ratings range from a high of 3 to a low of minus 1. Players rated below 0 always detract from return coverage, even if the special team coverage rule is not selected. Well, there you go. Home field advantage. And you can now set that from 1 to 5. Don't really know how that works, but you can change it now. So if you feel that the default home field advantage is too weak or too strong, you can change it. Defer. I never like to defer, but most teams do. Display offensive play, pre-play analysis. Display defensive mismatch warning box. Include league records and all-time book and the hash mark rules. Play using hash mark formula adjustments. Play result formulas are adjusted by field location. In general, plays run to the wider side of the field are more successful. Field goal attempts are more successful closer to the center of the field. Nice. Adjustments are minor for seasons with the modern hash mark locations, 72 to present, and more significant the closer the historical hash mark distance is to the sidelines. Hash mark location changes occurred in 1932, 35, 45, and 72. Hash marks did not exist prior to 1932. Hash mark formula adjustments are based on 5 locations, middle, left, right, and 4. Pre-32, wide left, and wide right, I'm assuming, and I know it happens when you assume, that you just put the ball wherever it was before 1932. Pro overtime, rule is for, the default is 15 minutes, in the 2010 rule. You'd play the 2022 rule for that. And overtime is 10 minutes. And for the playoffs, that's new. Oh, it would be the 2010 rule. So the overtime rule, sudden death, first team scores to win. 2010 rule, both teams guaranteed a possession unless the first team scores a touchdown. The new rule for this year is both teams are guaranteed a possession unless the defense causes a safety on the first possession of overtime. Structure. That seems to be all pretty much the same as it's been before. Usage. I never have penalties for those. So, but you can if you want. And there's now penalties for playing out of position, too. Injuries. I don't have multi-game injuries checked here. Partial game injuries are there. League injury preferences. Preset game day activities. Pre-game injuries. Limit regular season games to real life total. Post-game injuries. Overused players are more injury prone. That's nice. Exempt all quarterbacks from multi-game injuries. You can check that. Allow individual players to be marked as exempt from multi-game injuries. Yes. So if you want it, it's kind of the Dave Gardner rule. If you're trying to do a replay with Joe Montana or Steve Young, you can mark him. He can't get injured for more than one game. And allow deleting individual player injuries during a game. So yes. So if you don't want someone injured, you can shut that off. No limit on the maximum current players per roster or partial games. That's nice. Fatigue meter, that's the same as it's always been. Penalties, and you can change what you want for penalties. It's set to realistic in special situations. It's checked for defensive penalty on successful extra point, enforced on the kickoff, personal foul on a touchdown, enforced on the kickoff, personal foul on a field goal, option to apply to the next player on the kickoff, or penalty on the punt team, option to apply to the next player, repunt. Formations, and those are the ones that are checked. The 7-1 diamond, by the way, on the bottom right for defense, that's a new one. That is for if you're playing 50s team, because that's 50s teams, because that's some of the ones that they did. Quick play, I'm not really sure about that. I've never really touched it. And the display is pretty much the same. You can hide real stats if you want. We didn't change anything, so I think we're good. Oh, I did, but that's there. So, we want to do team stats. So, that's real life. So, that's what that screen is for the offense. The defense. So, it keeps track of those for real life. Special teams. And there's no injuries. There's a roster report. I didn't realize that Colt McCoy was still playing. What the game assigns for salaries. All right, and all the analysis stuff isn't there for real. So the schedule is all that unreal, and you can choose for any team, and so that's all good. And so at some point we'll actually show off a game playing for this, but I think that's about as much as I want to go for right now. And so that's my first look at Action PC Football 2022, and I'm going to tell you what I've seen so far looks pretty solid. Pretty solid indeed. We'll see if some of the errors that from before crop back up. If you bought the deluxe version, it came with a new season. And I'm 99% sure you can actually do an as-played replay with that. The other seasons were 57 and 78 that came with it. If you bought the Super Deluxe, you get, like, I think, 9 seasons overall. And the basic was there. It wasn't that. Let's see what the install was. So we're looking the Game folder. What was the default? No, 57, 78, and 21. So there you go. Good for them. All right. I'm Ron Juckett. Thank you so much for watching again. Thanks for all the kind words as my wife and I have recovered from COVID. And we expect to be doing some live streaming for you very soon. Have a good one, everybody.